We have a group of four students from Pune, very good students from the BJ Medical College. So suddenly called yesterday night and said, "Sir, there are 8 topics urgently, we need a review." So we had been on a Google Hangout. So till morning 3 o'clock we had been discussing. They are heading for the, they are now in Pondicherry taking the exam. Suddenly midnight, emergency crisis, like emergency physician called for a acute pulmonary embolic episode. So till morning, so I'm I had a very short sleep, but I'm quite sure the four of them, Prashant and his group, they might be doing very well in the JIPMER exam today for all that we have done till morning 3 o'clock. So this reason, you need to keep aside while preparing these 60 or 70 topics I will read last 1 week. Matlab, not first time. Don't do that. My last 1 week mein kya karna? Goa jana, samundar ke paar baith ke, kya kya revise karna? Because you need to be mentally very peaceful to the exam. For that you keep some 70-80 topics that ye to jarur review karne wala topics hai. But while preparing you need to decide what are the things to revise in the last. That will actually add a bit, but actually nothing adds. If your basics are well built, if your database of commonly asked things is well built, your concepts are strong, you will crack the exam. Simple secret. It's not that somebody read last moment my numericals, he will definitely answer better. Kuch bhi nahi hai wo. Common sense game, doctor, with a good guesswork, with some minimum basics which you need to have. That is the secret for winning the exam. So now, doctor, regarding pseudo hyperkalemia, what are the situations where it can happen? Suppose if you are taking the blood sample, what will nurse will do? Clench your fist, clench your fist. If you are clenching it too, not nurse's fist, your fist we are talking about. If you are clenching very hard, then that lead to development of breakage of the cells leading to hyperkalemia. Because potassium normally is intracellular, or release ho jayega. Hemolysis agar huye to, or leukocytosis or thrombocytosis, if it is there also, there is a pseudo hyperkalemia occur. Not penia, cytosis, osis mein. Now, Heer-Fort syndrome is fever plus parotid enlargement, as what you can see, facial palsy along with the anterior uveitis. The combination is called as Heer-Fort syndrome is what you need to basically understand. Eosinophilia myalgia syndrome bolne ke liye, what is the minimum criteria? Kitna eosinophil count hai to significantly is the part of the criteria. So basically, doctor, it should be 1000. More than 1000 cells per microliter is the recommendation. Otherwise, 1 into 10 to the power of 9 cells per liter. So the best answer would be option A. These last 3 questions in general medicine are tricky questions that can to certain extent decide the seat. These are all used in hyperkalemia. Insulin dextrose you will give because insulin drives the cell intracellularly. Dialysis, yes, when severe hyperkalemia is there in a renal failure, it's an indication per se for dialysis. It is the beta agonistic agents like terbutaline, albuterol are the ones which are used to lead to control the hyperkalemia. Beta agonists, not beta blockers. Beta blockers lead to hyperkalemia. NSAIDs lead to hyperkalemia. Even non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs also lead to hyperkalemia. So it is the beta agonist but not beta blockers. Procalcitonin is a marker of what? It is a marker of sepsis. Next exam, Bihar PG mat mein, shall I tell you what they will ask? Brain natriuretic peptide is an indicator of prognosis of which condition? CHF. That is going to be the next question. Polycystic kidney may, what are all the locations where you have the cysts? We have the cysts in liver, pancreas, heart and brain, not in the lung. Where is it given as lung? I know pathology textbook is Robbins. Liver, pancreas, brain are well known. Lung is not there, doctor. Cystic disease of the lung generally will have COPD, such kind of alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency like that. But this kind of simple question, main clean bold nahi hona actual exam mein. Diabetes management ke liye, which drug do you want to use? None of these drugs are in diabetic drugs, but which one is used in diabetes management? Chalo, what is your guesswork? Let us ask our online students. Chandu, Nandu, Balina, Shaz, Kiran, without you, our life is very stale. What is their answer? Let us check. What is your answer? Chalo. Our online students must. Yeah, very good. Raghav is proposing bromocriptine. Octreotide is Lavanya's answer. Octreotide. Pegvisomant. Octreotide. Aur kya hai? Nandu is proposing octreotide. Raghav is saying 10 years. Raghupati Raghava Rajaram only tells truth. Right? So, bromocriptine, doctor. Bromocriptine. Okay, I'll solve each of your points. Pegvisomant is going to come in the Bihar PG mat 2015. Growth hormone receptor antagonist. It is used for treatment of acromegaly. Then octreotide acetate. It is an injectable depot preparation used for the treatment of growth hormone producing tumors, once more for acromegaly. Then if a patient is having diabetes, then he will require less number of insulin and antidiabetics if octreotide is used. Okay, but if you tell bromocriptine, classically it is used in type 2 diabetes mellitus. So that's the reason bromocriptine become the correct answer, as Raghav told it correctly. That's right. Now, doctor, peripheral neuropathy may, what is the useful drug out of all this? What is the only drug that we don't know? Iparistat. We don't know what is this, but that is the one. It is the aldose reductase inhibitor. What is the pathophysiology of diabetic neuropathy? Excess glucose will convert into sorbitol by the action of aldose reductase. Sorbitol will do all dirty things in lens and nerves. So inhibit aldose reductase by giving iparistat is the one which need to be remembered. This is going to be straight repeat in the next future exam. So be very sure on this, doctor. Small cell carcinoma mein kya hota? By the time you diagnose, only patient will be in a metastatic stage. It's very rapid in its progression to deterioration. Poorest prognosis. That's the reason there is no time for clubbing. Clubbing develop hone ke liye thode kuch saal bronchogenic carcinoma should be there. If patient dies before that, no clubbing seen. So small cell carcinoma may, there is no time for clubbing to evolve, is what you need to remember. According to American Diabetic Association, when will you diagnose the diabetes, doctor? If it is more than 126 milligram per deciliter, if that is the fasting glucose, is what need to be remembered. Positive Kernicke's, easiest question in the world, meningitis. Podagra will be found in gout. Examiner don't want to disappoint you. So simple question. Pheochromocytoma, may don't put FNAC and try to do Nobel Prize winning investigation. Patient will die. You touch only, it will release catecholamines. That's the point. So don't do FNAC. What is Marriac syndrome? Basically, Marriac syndrome, may patient will get Cushing's. This is a case of Marriac, where round face, pot belly. Another case of Cushing appearance is there, no? So, typically they will have hepatomegaly and growth impairment, Cushingoid features, type 1 diabetes mellitus. So, all these will be classically present in an adolescent, becomes a Marriac. This question will never come in any other exam. This is only to check whether paper is already leaked for you or are you a G9 student. Even this also you answer correct means too much. Avoiding response means what? Switching off the phone, removing Facebook profile and then totally changing the boyfriend. Is it called avoiding reflex? So basically it is a reflex seen in contralateral parietal lobe lesions. What is that? It can be physiological avoiding reflex. There can be pathological avoiding response reflex. Suppose if you are doing a contact stimulus along the ulnar border of the hand, then all fingers will go into abduction in a infant, which is called physiological avoiding reflex. It is called. You can see, you can touch the baby's ulnar border. Immediately they will do like this. Then if there is any cerebral palsy, even in them, if you touch along their ulnar border, they will typically show overextension of fingers, overextension, flexion, extension, along with abduction. So typically this is pathological form of avoiding response reflex, which is seen in parietal lobe lesion. Anyway, since examiner asked this question, what are the 6 other possible questions examiner can ask in the next exam? Palmomental reflex, where do you find? Those who had a anoxic brain injury, if you happen to touch their palm, right, immediately they will bite their lip. Palmomental, not dismental, dismental. Mentum is there, no? Mental reflex. So, if you touch their palm, immediately they will bite their lip, which is called as palmomental reflex. Then snouting reflex, when there is a bilateral UMN lesion. Then glabellar tap reflex is seen in Parkinsonism and senile dementia. Then dyslexia, which is inability to read, is a feature of dominant parietal lobe lesion. Then dysgraphia, inability to write, is a feature of either frontal or parietal lobe lesion. Recent times, November also, there was a question on inattention is a feature of which lobar lesion? Frontal or parietal lobe was the question of the examiner. So, kyon aise questions aate hain? Kyunki kismat. It is a predictable written kismat. Examiner's question bank is some expectations hai. Aap aa rahe bole to ye cheeze aapko malum hai ya nahi test karne ke liye, they are all predecided in the last janma. Right, there is in near Pondicherry, there is something called leaf astrology. In those days, when we used to go to Pondicherry or Chandigarh or any entrance, means it's a vacation fundamentally. So, chalo yaar, kaise bhi jipmer paper mein ek question bhi maalo, samajh mein nahi aaya, jaake wo leaf astrology mein dekhenge and ask him when we will get PG seat. So, in that all the name, everything of the person is pre-written. I mean, I never had a trust on that. But it's a good fun to go and check. If you have trust, that's a different thing. So, examiner's question bank is also like astrology leaf, where pre-decided 1132 topics are there. 80% paper will come. Lobar lesions is one definite question, doctor. Padna hai aap. So, ultrasound in a 3-year-old child.
3 centimeter circumscribed hypoequiclesion. Every time pediatrics means one neuroblastoma or one leukemia or one Wilms tumor. इसके बिना कभी 10 questions खत्म होते क्या? नहीं होते. तो you should remember, neuroblastoma is what you see in 1 year infant में, within first 1 year. Wilms tumor median age is 3.5 years. Wilms tumor will present like a hypoechoic lesion as what you can see on the ultrasound. Wilms tumor. Then if I say the highest incidence in the first year of life was tumor, that becomes the neuroblastoma. And similarly, most common cancer in infancy, if that is an MCQ, that becomes neuroblastoma. Infancy mein most common cancer bole to. Most common extracranial solid tumor in childhood, that will be neuroblastoma. Even that is not Wilms. Then most common childhood abdominal malignancy, that is the frame of MCQ of the examiner, then answer becomes Wilms tumor. The median age at the diagnosis of the Wilms tumor kitne saal hota? 3.5 years. And first year of life mein, you should remember neuroblastoma. N for newborn, N for neuroblastoma. Okay? Ha. Koebner phenomena, you will see it in psoriasis. Dapsone ka half-life kitna hai? There are only about 6 drugs whose half-life you should know. Digoxin, digitoxin, emidoron, lithium, dapsone. We will publish on the news for medico.com. Only 6 or 10 drugs, don't read more than that. Half-lives of the drugs. Similarly, 6 to 10 incubation periods. Don't read more than that. Even if textbook is there, MCQ books will tell, read this, this is a good, good point. How far you will remember, you can. So like that, you should limit your rememberable memorables into not more than 10 for a given heading. So it is 24 hours. Elimination half-life is about actually 30 hours. Nearest figure is 24 hours. Alopecia areata. Typically, how do you treat, doctor? You will treat it by giving minoxidil is considered to be the part of the management. Then rhinophyma is typically due to acne rosacea is what you need to remember. Comedones are a feature which you see in case of acne vulgaris. Aap Bihar jao ya Bengal jao, Patna de ya Pondicherry gaye, aapke piche kaun aayega? Mapleson anesthesia system ek to jarur aayega. Right? So if you didn't read this dirtiest topic in anesthesia, which type of ventilator system difficult to clear the sewage called as PG preparation. So doctor, it is Mapleson A which is the circuit of choice if there is a spontaneous respiration. Mapleson B and Bain are modifications for controlled ventilation. For neonates and pediatric patients, it is Mapleson E and F is what you have to basically remember. F is called Jackson-Rees modification. So, once more in All India, also they will ask the same question. Then, muscle relaxants cannot be used for what purpose? They are used for facilitating intubation, to optimize surgical condition. Surgeons will be shouting, no, make it loose, make it loose, while operating. So accordingly, the anesthetist will be altering the dosages. It is not for providing sedation. What is sedation? What is hypnosis? Producing sleep is called hypnosis. Anxiolysis is called sedation. Generally we think sedative means which promotes sleep. No, wrong. Hypnotics are sleep promoting. Anxiolytics are all sedatives. Benzodiazepine is a sedative because it is anxiolytic. That is not the purpose of giving muscle relaxant is what you need to basically remember. That is a mental relaxation, not muscle relaxation. Right? Then, patient controlled analgesia. I am not very sure exactly what would have been the most correct answer, but it will provide immediate medication delivery, less contact of nursing staff, patient control will be there on the pain. I think answer should be C. We will commit down the line on the correct answer. Now, Hoffman's degradation kya hota hai? Molecular rearrangement hota hai. It is a non-enzymatic degradation is what you need to remember. Then, the most frequent type of hysterical pain. This also exact answer I am not sure, but I think headache is more common than abdominal pain. I reviewed some literature. This is a tentative answer. Narcolepsy is triggered by what? So basically all of our sleeping pattern, everything is decided by your limbic system, right? So hypothalamus is the one which is associated with any sleep associated disorder like narcolepsy, cataplexy, etc. Claustrophobia is a fear for closed spaces like elevators, etc. Then in alcoholism, what is the characteristic delusion? Checking the wife's emails, husband's SMSs, most dangerous activity that is. You are intruding into one's personal arena, right into the crevices and depths of his personality, which is ugly for any person. So that is the reason that will be more if there is alcoholism. Then that lead to development of delusions of infidelity. The doubting Thomas is the one which basically is most common delusion. Splenic rupture ho gaya. In fact, all of these are the radiological signs you will see. But what is most reliable radiological sign is a important thing. It is the indentation of the left side of the air bubble of the stomach. Due to the splenic hematoma is considered to be most reliable out of all. I leave the literature for you as to what supports this explanation. You need to review that. How will you identify posterior urethral wall, doctor? You will do micturating sister urethrogram is what you need to remember. So when will you repair posterior urethral valve? When will you manage it? Only by giving antibiotics. Every AIMS entrance you go, this is a favorite topic. Right? You have to review that. Corkscrew esophagus, diffuse esophageal spasm. One question on either achalasia or one of the motility disorders will always be in the entrance. Antenatal double bubble sign, one in stomach, other is in duodenum, is a feature of duodenal atresia. Hypertrophic pyloric stenosis may, you have metabolic alkalosis but the paradoxical aciduria. So what is the meaning of this? Paradoxical aciduria. So typically in a person who has pyloric stenosis, all the contents of his esophagus, he will be vomiting. The baby will be vomiting. Because of this, what will be there? He will have dehydration. Dehydration will decrease the renal perfusion. That will increase the renin production, angiotensin, aldosterone become elevated. What is the effect of aldosterone on the renal tubule? It will lead to retention of sodium, loss of potassium into urine, along with that loss of H plus ion into urine. So excess H plus ion in the urine will lead to aciduria. Then why it is called paradoxical aciduria? Because the person is vomiting in hypertrophic pyloric stenosis, what is he vomiting? Contents in the stomach which are acidic by nature. When a person vomits acid, what do you expect kidney to do? Retain acid. Instead, what is kidney doing here? Losing acid into urine due to secondary hyperalosmolism. Hence, it is called paradoxical aciduria is what you need to basically remember. In hyperthyroidism during pregnancy, we don't give radioiodine, that goes with common sense. 24 year old has fallen down, he lapses into coma and you need to relieve the intracranial tension. So craniotomy become the high preference. What is the recent Dames question? A person had a road traffic accident and he had a unilateral pupillary dilatation, then do you want to do Barthol on the contralateral side or the ipsilateral side? So one head injury guaranteed question hota hai kahi bhi entrance of guy and management of raised intracranial tension. Okay, recent PGI also there was a question on intracranial tension. Okay, so you need to review that. Hemorrhoids, typically where is the external hemorrhoid found, doctor? Below the pectinate line, and that is the place where you, what do you have, who is supplying the nerve supply? Typically it is supplied by the somatic nerve, which is pudendal nerve. So internal hemorrhoids are not painful unless they have thrombus, and external hemorrhoids are painful due to pudendal nerve. Now patient is having carcinoma colon 4 months back and has isolated metastasis into the liver. What do you want to do with that? Isolated metastasis can always be resected in few tumors, which you need to know the list. So what is Zollinger Ellison? It is hypergastrinemia with a raised gastric output with a non-beta cell tumor is what you need to remember. Suppose the patient is comatose for a long period of time, you want to use a jejunostomy tube. TPN is a very high yielding topic in entrance exam. Total parenteral nutrition, complications, what are the agents used, everything. We have hosted on the newsformedico.com a web page dedicated for TPN topic, common MCQs asked in the that you can revise. Now doctor, 26 year old, thyroid nodule, amyloid, stroma of the lesion, suggestive of medullary carcinoma of the thyroid. What is the choice you want to do? In case of medullary carcinoma of thyroid, recurrence rate is very high if you leave even a small bit. So total thyroidectomy, modified neck dissection on the side of the enlarged lymph node is considered to be the management of choice. Matt Bernice incision, iliohypogastric nerve is a very close relationship and it can become injured. Similarly, out of all this, it is the erythroplakia, which is the most premalignant lesion, is what you need to understand. If you take the adenocarcinoma, it is the Barrett's esophagus which is responsible. For cholecystitis, what is mediating all that chemical injury? So, typically, it is trypsin from pancreatic juice, unconjugated bile salts, and the phospholipid lysolecithin. They are all the important chemical mediators of the damage which is caused to the wall of the gallbladder, is what you need to remember. Now, what is the paraneoplastic syndrome in esophageal carcinoma? So, it is the peripheral neuritis, motor neuronopathy will occur. Another very common question is stylosis, is another important feature you see in case of esophageal carcinoma. Is what you need to remember. 59 year old is having dysphagia to solids. There is a smooth stricture. Whenever there is any stricture of the esophagus, it can be due to malignancy or it can be due to reflux esophagitis. What is the differentiator between the two? A smooth surface is a feature of, when you do endoscopy, is a feature of reflux esophagitis associated stricture. That's the point you need to understand. So, if you need, acid suppression is not adequate, then and if a frequent dilatation of that stricture you have to do, then surgery is indicated, is what you need to basically remember. Okay, doctor? Then, I'll leave the literature for you to review on this. A bone scan, what will you basically use? It is a technetium label substitute of the biphosphonates is what is classically used. Now doctor, in case of extensive varicose veins, what is not a true statement? To not use surgical intervention is wrong. We use the surgical intervention whenever varicose veins become too extensive. But generally, otherwise varicose veins ke liye surgery not indicated, only for cosmetic reason we do. But when they are very severe, then that becomes an indication. So all the remaining statements are true. Okay, I leave the literature for you, what are the indications for varicose vein surgery, etc. Testicular biopsy kab karenge? Azoospermia becomes an indication for doing with a palpable vasa differentia, if there is a azoospermia, you need to basically do testicular biopsy. Lower esophageal sphincter, all of them will lead to development of sphincteric relaxation. Ramstead in hypertrophic pyloric stenosis. Then whenever there is a gastric carcinoma, Ramstead is for pyloric stenosis. What was there in the alternative wrong answer? Earlier question or this question? We'll catch up with that. And now we are going like Shatabdi Express. Bihar to Hyderabad. We have to finish the paper little fast. But any doubts are there, please do punch into the... I'm very happy to see about 40 viewers online in spite of Jipmer Festival, Carnival. And Now, doctor, if you take gastric carcinoma, polypoidal lesions are one type, spreading lesions are another type, ulcerative lesions are another type. Out of all, always the rule is a polypoid lesion will have a better prognosis compared to that of a spreading lesion, is what you have to basically remember. Okay, doctor. Now, in papillary thyroid carcinoma, typically you can do local lymph node spread management by doing cervical block dissection, and post lobectomy you need to give thyroxine so that you will suppress the TSH level and prevent the recurrence from happening. They are all the true statements. Okay. Now, catabolic surgical patient hair, what are the main change that will occur in the body composition? Total body water will increase, adipose tissue decrease, body weight decreases. But what happens to lean body mass? It represents the compartment that contains proteins. Since it is a catabolic state of critical illness, there is a diminished amount of lean body mass is what you need to remember. Any objection, Lavanya? Total body water will increase. Total body water typically will increase. What is the underlying pathophysiological cause? I leave hypoalbuminemia leading to water retention. Retention in the extravascular compartment. Our students have become experts like the teacher to give answer for any question. So basically, if your physiology is good and general medicine is good, you can reason out anything. But are you sure on that? Okay, good. Hopefully. Then usually gallstones, what do they contain? Oxalate and bile pigments, pigmented stones. They contain cholesterol, calcium oxalate, but not bile salt. That's the point. In fact, less amount of bile salt precipitates the stone formation, because salt has got a solubilizing effect on the prevention of gallstone. Okay. Now, whenever there is any severe injury, you get a negative nitrogen balance, not positive nitrogen balance. I think some good questions are there in Bihar PGMAT, which can be seat fixing in nature. Now, Montezuma's revenge is what? So basically, Delhi belly, turkey trot, Montezuma's revenge, they are the other colorful names for the traveler's diarrhea, basically. Hypospadiasme, what do you get? So fundamentally, you have a hooded penis, spatulated glands, meatal stenosis, ventral cordae. So these are the important changes. So typically, this is called modified Koyanagi's procedure. You have a Koyanagi-Harada syndrome. I don't threaten you by too much unheard names. So Koyanagi procedure for a severe posterior hypospadias. Preoperatively, how it was, it is a very severe penoscrotal junction may you have a meatus of the urethra. So post-operatively patient is able to have a good stream of urine is what you are able to see. So hypospadias, epispadias is one very common topic, doctor. Then umbilical divarication of recti, omphalocele, even that is also high yield topic for surgery. Now for preoperative complications, what is the major determinant in an individual patient's risk? It is the surgical procedure itself is most important determinant of individual patient risk for a perioperative complication. What type of surgery you do, how decently you do, how delicately you do, or did you suture the things like the way a tailor sutures, or did you did it like a surgeon sutures, they all matter. Collens is hemorrhagic pancreatitis by periumbilical distribution of that hemorrhagic fluid is basically the collens. Cat gut is not from cat, it is from sheep's gut, one of the repeatedly asked MCQ. Regarding surgical stress response, if you take cytokines, it is direct cell to cell communication that they work locally. So they have more of paracrine, apocrine than the endocrine effects. So differences between cytokines and hormones, I leave the literature for you. Now doctor, lateral condyle got fractured, it won't grow, only medial aspect of the leg is growing, then the both legs will leave each other and typically what you get is called genu valgum. If medial growth plate is injured, then lateral will grow too much and that lead to genu varum is what need to be remembered. So I think you remember genu valgum, genu varum, genu recurvatum is one of the very high yield topic which we discussed in the recent 62 topics in orthopedics. Only you need to read 62 topics in orthopedics. We left that PDF of that 62 topics notes on the download section of newsformedico.com. You can download it and review the quick point wise notes. What are the common points asked as MCQs in exam? And also we have video discussion on anatomy2medicine.com. So doctor, surgical neck of humerus, neck no, oh I am just suddenly thinking of radial nerve, surgical neck is axillary nerve, good. The entire body weight is transferred by vertebral body. So in which locations there is a concertina like collapse of the spine is a very common question in tuberculosis. Then joint in the knee is what type of joint? It is a diarthrotic joint. Knee is the largest and the most complex diarthrosis that you see in the body is what you need to remember. That's the reason what is the importance of any tibial fracture. Tibial fracture ho gaya to toda malunion hai to bhi upar wala knee joint is diarthroidal, niche wala ankle bhi not multi-axial. So any malunion will affect the typically the leg movements. So any malunion is not permissible. But a shoulder is not like that. If you take elbow can move more freely and shoulder to completely it is free. That's the reason any humerus fracture may malunion hai to it is still tolerable. I think you remember what we discussed in orthopedics class Monday to Friday. Winging of the scapula is a feature seen with long thoracic nerve. Caffey's disease may, what will you basically use? Caffey is there is no specific treatment, but corticosteroids are effective to alleviate the systemic symptoms which you see in case of Caffey's disease. Then Blount's disease means what? So now you know genu is such a favorite topic for Bihar PG mat or any other PG mats also. So you must read genu abnormalities. So it is the genu, it is also called tibia vara, Blount's disease, it's called the bow leg, that's the reason called tibia vara. Now avascular necrosis of bone very common in scaphoid. whenever there is any waste of the scaphoid fracture. Proximal or distal segment? Proximal segment is the one which is basically infarcted. What is the normal acetabular angle is a very important MCQ. 35 to 37 degrees is normal acetabular angle. Generally between 33 to 38. For skeletal traction, we use Steenman pin, Krishna's wire and Bowler's stirrup. In one of the topics, high yield 62 topics, one topic is screws, nuts, bolts in orthopedic gadgets. Is a high yield topic. Rush pin is not used for skeletal traction. It is used basically to maintain the reduction in the long bone fracture, as in the case of the femur. You will drive the rush pin. Stirrup, everything is used for skeletal traction. Then, Puschner's retinopathy is a feature of pancreatitis, one of the repeatedly asked questions. Commonest tumor at inner canthus would be erodent ulcer, basal cell carcinoma. Then, greatest concentration of the rods kaha hota hai? Anybody answered fovea? Fovea? Typically, there is a central part which is called fovea in the vision. Parafoveal area. Then you have a peripheral area of the vision. Right? So, generally it is a perifoveal area which is considered with the location for the highest concentration of the rods. Commonest intraorbital tumor causing exophthalmos would be a hemangioma. Is what you need to remember. Bitart spots. Bolo. Anybody answer cornea? Hey, you will get ice cream if you say. Lavanya gets for ice cream. So, there is a temptation. Vitamin A deficiency may corneal xerosis will be there. Keratomalacia will be there. If you don't know any of them, you will answer correct answer. Conjunctiva. Wo to hai. So, typically, it is in the conjunctiva. Right. For the earlier question, Shweta asked, Cullen's, why not acute pancreatitis but hemorrhage? You find hemorrhage in the retroperitoneal area and periumbilically. So, it is hemorrhagic pancreatitis. I think Shweta has answered. I have seen it little later. Okay. Right. Karthik is reporting no audio. Can others can tell whether audio is clear? Yeah. Aqueous pressure is higher than ICT by how much? I don't know how to decide the correct answer for this, but I will tell you actual statistics. What is the average IOP? 10 to 21 millimeters mercury. Whereas the average intracranial pressure is 5 to 15. So I think the answer should be 6 to 10 millimeters of mercury should be the answer. Very good. Now, Holmgren's wool matching. What is the next question? Bihar PG Mat 2015. Ishihara charts are used where? Color blindness is what need to be remembered. Regarding glaucoma, without glaucoma, cataract, Pondicherry gayo, Bihar gayo, jarur hoga a question. Glaucoma. So, doctor, it is measured by tonometry. Easy question. There are a lot of glaucoma drugs generally examiner will ask. What is the recent question? AIIMS November 2014. Brimonidine is a category C. That was in PGA or in AIIMS? Brimonidine contraindication in pregnancy. Recent question. Right. Retinal detachment, how will you treat? Basically, you can use cryosurgery in order to build to close the holes in the retinal detachment. But one question will come, exudative, tractional retinal detachment, list of causes, everything in retinal detachment, to padna hi padega. Then, lacrimal gland is supplied by what? Actually, I see two possibilities. One is, anyway, sympathetic ganglion sends fibers. Then, if you look at the parasympathetic nerve supply, it basically comes from the secretomotor fibers basically come from the trigeminal's maxillary division. But what he gave was not trigeminal nerve, but trigeminal ganglion. So I consider sympathetic chain ganglion, so definitely cervical sympathetic plexus supply the lacrimals. But there is a literature on what is the parasympathetic nerve supply, which you need to basically review. Now, doctor, what is the incorrect pair? Basically, otoliths, are they in semicircular canal or where are they found? Utricle and saccule. Okay. Hind's pharyngoplasty. In order to improve speech, we do Hind's pharyngoplasty. Cricothyroid is the only muscle not supplied by the regular vagus, but by supplied by external laryngeal branch of the vagus, which is superior laryngeal. It is not supplied by recurrent laryngeal. So once more, vocal cord nerve supply, vocal cord types of paralysis, high yield topic in ENT. There are totally 70 topics in ENT. At least the first 30 topics you have to review. Now, where will natural lacrimal duct open into inferior meatus? Millard's rule of 10, cleft lip pellet ke bina. Recently AIMS mein aaya, PGI November 2014 mein aaya, JIPMER mein bhi aayega. Parso hum discussion le lenge na. So Millard's rule of 10 says 10 pounds, which is 5 kgs, not 10 kgs. That's fix in that. If you give antiretroviral prophylaxis, what will happen? Typically, it will diminish by about, the transmission will diminish by about 35%. Then out of all this, which is not a ovulation inducing drug, HMG is also ovulation inducing drug. So if you take chloramadinone acetate is also called CMA. What is that? It is a steroidal progestin which has anti-androgenic effect, hence used as a contraception, not as ovulation inducing drug. That's the point. Normal adult vaginal pH will be how much? So it will be between 4 to 5, which will be 4.5. Spermatogonium factory mein kitne din lagega manufacturing hone ke liye? So it takes about 74 days actually. So 72 days is the nearest figure. So they are the set of Bihar PGMAT questions.